Hi guys, I'm Putsi and welcome to my reaction channel. As you can see by the title, this is going to be a reaction to All Too Well 10 Minutes version by none other than Taylor Swift. Red Taylor's version just come out. I will be reacting to the whole entire Red Taylor's version after this one, but I just need to listen to this song first. So my brain is still in a good condition. I'm not gonna feel overwhelmed because I feel like if I do this, like this song is dead last on the album, and I don't think I will be able to survive that long without thinking about this song. And by the time we reach this song, I don't think I can handle it. I'm scared for that version of me in the future. All Too Well is regarded as one of Taylor Swift's best songs and widely loved. And since the original Red came out, Taylor herself said that there's a 10-minute version of the song, the original one. Ever since then, we've been waiting for it. I feel like I hate that Taylor has to re-record all of her album. It was really, really bad and tragic what happened to her and her previous and just the whole drama, the whole selling her masters and everything. But if we can have one silver lining, is that now we get the chance to listen to all of the full songs, specifically this one. And we've been waiting, we've been begging for this one to, like, please include this in the Red Taylor's version. And she listened, she gives us what we want, and now it's here. But like, I've been waiting for it. I know it exists, I know she will release this for months, but I'm still not ready. But anyway, I'm so excited. There will be a short film. This week is going to be one of the best week of 2021 for sure. I just listened to Little Mix Between Us, this album, the song, the short film, all of the interviews, all the reaction. The promo for this album has been crazy, way more promo for the whole entire Folklore, Evermore, Fearless, Taylor's version combined. Like, it was probably because of the pandemic, but wow. Oh, by the way, Red plaid shirts because of All Too Well plaid shirts day. Also have a coffee ready with me. So all we know, there were a lot of rumors, especially on Twitter, that All Too Well 10 Minutes version will include 3 new verses. Like, let that sink in. Longer second chorus. Double bridge. How am I supposed to survive that? Double bridge. I barely survived the original bridge. We will also have some new pre-choruses, so okay, without further ado. Wait, I'm still not ready, but I cannot wait any further. By the way, I already have the lyric pulled up, so I will be listening while reading the lyrics. I have opened this up, but I haven't looked through it yet because I don't want to get spoilers. So, okay, let's go. Oh my god, I love the intro part. There's a second guitar. Did you hear that? There's the main guitar that we get from the shoulder version of All Too Well. I mean, this is the original one, but I'm gonna call that the original version, or the old All Too Well. From the old version, I feel like it was only one guitar, right? But this one, like, you can barely hear it. There's a second kind of in harmony with the main guitar. It sounds like an effect. It's so cool. It's very faint, but it's right there. I walked to the door with you. The air was cold. I'm sorry for pausing. I know it's only 27 seconds, but oh my god, I just got chills. Oh my god, I don't know how I'm gonna survive 10 minutes of this. Okay, I'm gonna restart. There was also kind of a crackling sound at the start there. Oh my god, I love that guitar part so much. It adds in to the whole atmosphere of the song, and her voice sounds beautiful. I walked to the door with you. The air was cold, but something about it felt like home somehow. And I left my scarf there at your sister's house, and you still got it in your drawer even now. Oh my god, her voice has never sound better. Like, this is what I'm most excited about. Her voice has matured so much over the last couple of years, and getting better and better. Her vocal control is better, and she also have more vibrato in her voice now, because I feel like before she doesn't really do vibrato that part. Wait, there was a very faint kind of like trickling, sparkling sound that was beautiful. Oh, your sweet disposition, my wide eyed gaze. We're singing in the car, getting lost up in state. Autumn leaves falling down like pieces in a place, and I can picture it after all these days. And I know it's long gone, and that magic's not here no more. And I might be okay, but I'm not. See that simmering effect. Here we are again on that little town street. I love the shimmering effect, but she harmonized herself there and it sounds amazing. And also I like the beat even more in this one. I feel like it's way more prominent and a little bit more punchy. You almost ran the red, cause you were looking over me. Wind in my hair, I was there, I remember it all too well. Oh, there's also a different guitar. Your cheek would turn red, it used to be a little gift. Okay, there's also new, you know that, oh, I just hit my own eye. There was also new, yeah. I feel like she perfected this song. Your mother's telling stories about you on the T-ball team. You told me about your past, thinking your future was me. And you were tossing me the car keys, but the page. Okay, that was new. Oh my god, that's new. I wasn't ready for that. Wow, I was just ready to sing along. You told me about your past, but the harmony. That was like a completely new song. What the heck was that? Wow, that was a completely different melody. It's completely different from the first. The first and second verse in the old version sounds, you know, have the same melody, but that one was just completely different. And I was thinking on the drive down, anytime now, he's gonna say it's love. You never called it what it was. Taylor feel that she's in love and she expected him to say for what it was, it's love. It's pretty much a one-sided love, or at least she's the only person who are committed, invest herself in the relationship. Oh my god. Check the pulse and come back swearing it's the same after 3 months in the grave. And then you wondered where it went to as I reached for you, but all I felt was shame, and you held my lifeless friend. Oh my god, I love the instrumentation so much. Like Taylor does a lot of harmony in there in the background, like ha ha. There's also a humming part very faintly in the back, and I love that. And then you wondered where it went to as I reached for you, but all I felt was shame, and you held my lifeless frame. Oh my god, this is even more heartbreaking than the original version. What the heck. Still we are again in the middle of the night. We're dancing around the kitchen in the refrigerator light. Down the stairs, I was there, I remember it all too well. Okay, this is new. But I kept you like an old sacred prayer, and we'd swear to that part leading up to the bridge, it doesn't build up as much as the old version, but I feel like it's going to come in the second bridge. This part, I feel like she kept it in more of a similar pace, similar volume, similar energy, a lot more new detail about the relationship. You kept me like a secret, but I kept you like an oath. It's obviously not a very balanced relationship. She put so much of herself into the relationship, but obviously Jake didn't. Kept me like a secret. Is it because Taylor was way younger than him? Is it because he felt ashamed of the relationship, of her, because she's a pop star and, you know, he only likes indie record and stuff? Or was it because he actually have someone out there? But I kept you like an oath. Like, who does that in a lyric? Like, wow. There were a lot more harmonies going on in the background. Oh my god, I just got chills. Why did she hit us immediately right after the bridge? Like, I didn't have time to breathe at all. They say all's well that ends well. She used that from Lover, but in Lover it's obviously describing love instead of a breakup. We love that for her. They say all's well that ends well, but I'm in a new hell. You said if we had been closer in age, maybe it would have been fine. Wow, their age gap is actually kind of crazy. If they are in a relationship now, I feel like they will get more backlash maybe about it, because she was obviously only like 19-20 years old at the time. She's not as crazy as John Mayer, but still, why are you saying that now? There's always an age gap before you get into the relationship. Why do you have to get into it first and then break her heart, treat her like that, and use it as a way to get out of it, like to defend yourself? You obviously felt like it was fine when she started it, but now when it's going down to hell, you feel like it's a problem? What the heck? God, that is even more heartbreaking than the original All Too Well. The moment I knew the idea you had of me, who was she? He painted this picture of her in his head, but she doesn't recognize that girl. Obviously, from Begin Again, we know she feels some kind of shame for being herself, because he doesn't like the real version of her. He made her feel like she should change it, which is not cool. Whose shine reflects on you? He only painted this beautiful picture of her to fit his narrative, to fit his image. Weeping in a party bathroom, some actress asking me what happened. Who is this actress? I need to know. That's what happened to you. Turning 21. obviously is referring to the moment I knew moment when he obviously didn't come to her birthday party. I love the way she sang paralyzed there. But I'm still trying to find it after plaid shirt days, and that's when you made me your own. Plaid shirt days. My things and I walk home alone, but you keep my old scarf. Oh, the beat here is deep on the drum. Cause it reminds you of innocence, and it smells like me. You can't get rid of it, cause you remember. There's a lot more harmony there in the background. I love every single little harmony. The one she added in, just all the details in this version is so amazing. And also the drum in this part specifically feels more like more grand. Real thing you've ever known. Oh, it's snow. It's supposed to end. We're still going to have a couple of more parts. It's only been 7.5 minutes, but that was new. Not new, the post-chorus, but that you remember it all. The chanting in the background feels like an echo of her thought, you know, because she obviously mentioned a lot of about keep remembering things about him. It echoes in her mind, like that sounds like her own echo that she heard in her brain, in her own head. Wow. Oh my god, I love that. I get older, but your lovers stay my age. That sounds like Jack Antonoff thing to do. The beat there, is it? Who produced this one? It is produced by Jack Antonoff and Taylor Swift. Obviously, I immediately recognize the sound of that synth, the beat in the background there at that very specific part. And he also played guitars and everything, which thank you, Jack. I love all the little guitar addition. That beat made the song feels very current, and it's very much Jack Antonoff production. And I was never good at telling jokes, but the punchline goes, I'll get older, but your lovers stay my age. From when you're Brooklyn broke my skin and bones, I'm a soldier who's returning half her weight. Oh, she really take a dig at Jake Gyllenhaal. Punchline goes, I'll get older, but your lovers, with an S, plural, your lovers stay my age. So even as he gets older, he keeps dating 19, 20 years old girls, young adult. Wow. If I'm Jake Gyllenhaal right now, I need to immediately go into hiding and don't come out until 2023 at least. The twin flame blues paint you blue. Oh, I love just that harmony there. The love affair made you too, cause in the cities they're in court. Oh, that's the lyric from that one. Was it a TikTok or something, or a clue somewhere, a video somewhere, where she wrote down a lyric, and it's this lyric right here. The guitar. Oh, that goes really down and deep there. Amazing. Just between us did the love. did she manage to have that very different melody and bring it back to the original old melody? It's crazy. Melody in the back there, the harmony, oh my god. Just between us, oh my god, that call and response thing. That sounds like another echo in her from her thoughts. What the hell? That and also the product and the way they produce this, it really sounds like an echo. Oh my god, I just got chills. Is it going to fade out? It's a very slow fade out, but I love that. What an epic ending for an epic song. I feel like the very slow fade out is perfect for the progression of the song and her thought process, because this relationship felt like an echo. It keeps coming back to her, all of the echoes in her mind. Slowly but surely fading out, but it's a long, long time before she finally feels okay. It took her a long time to get over it, but at the very least, she finally moved on. And it fits that slow fade out very well, in my opinion. I cannot believe how different all the melodies for all the new parts sounds. The structure different, but it all flows beautifully. All the new addition sounds way more cathartic. It just feels like a flow of consciousness pouring out of her. But I mean, it was obviously how the song was written. She just doing it on the spot. I love this one even more than the original one, and I don't know how that's even possible, because I feel like it feels more organic and more raw. The production of it is very lovely. I love all the little guitar parts in the background. I love the drums. It feels softer at some parts, but it also punched a bit harder than the old version in some parts. I've been sitting here and filming for more than half an hour, and I didn't realize that it's been that long, because the song flown by so quickly. I did not get bored whatsoever, because the song didn't stay at the same place. It always changing. This is one of her best song. Now, I still have a lot more songs to go through, because I'm going to react to the whole entire Red Taylor's version, but I cannot wait any longer. I'm excited, but I feel like I need to drink a lot more water and refresh myself, hydrate myself, because that was a journey. But yeah, I hope you enjoy that reaction. Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you like this 10-minute version, or do you like the old version more? What's your favorite part of this 10-minute version? I wanna know. Chat down below, discuss. If you like this reaction video, give this video a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. I will post more Taylor Swift content in the future, music reaction, movie TV reaction, and all of that. For now, it's goodbye. Thank you so much for watching. I hope I can see you again in my next video. Bye guys.